What's up, Madden 17 fans? My name is Cody. I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're continuing the series in basically what I would like to call just kind of gameplay studies or film study or whatever you want to call it. Like, what we're really trying to get accomplished here is live gameplay, live tournament, great players playing good competition up in the leaderboards. What am I going to do? How do I play? How do I execute some of the things that I talk about in the tip videos? And so, just kind of wanted to share this with you, so this is going to be a good game. We got pretty good internet here, so we should have no problem with connection this time, and hopefully we'll have a pretty smooth game here. So what this goal of it is the whole goal here is to try to give you some practical, like, film analysis of, like, what do I do, why do I do it, and so hopefully that will help you going forward here. So first play, first drive. I mean, you'll see. I probably call Tampa to probably 80% of the time. I mean, it is definitely the main play you're going to see me call. What makes it so good is everything else. If you watch, different situations require different types of things here. So there we go. There's a stop. So first down, we called it. He ran the ball. Part of the reason we call 4-3 under is because it's very, very effective against the run. In my opinion, it's a very good formation. I mean, it just does a lot of good things. And so I really like that about the formation. It sets me up well to stop the run. And then on second down, we got a sack. Because he hesitated, because he was going with a little levels play concept, and we were able to shut that down. And then the third play, we've got a bat down. So a lot of several different things that occurred there. So starting out, we're going to power Derrick Henry, see what we can do with him. What you want to do when you're on offense is keep it, again, and I'll reiterate, keep it simple. I mean, if you watch all of my gameplays, they look very similar. Like, the pattern is there. What you just got to figure out is what's he doing. So is he blitzing off the left edge? Is he blitzing off the right edge? Oh, I hit the wrong button. Oh my gosh, I had my running back wide open. I thought my running back was R1, not triangle or whatever he was. Bumped the wrong button there. So, like, if you notice, like, in this situation, so pre-snap read, pre-snap analysis, he's probably not blitzing me because he can't really blitz me from anywhere. Maybe a left side blitz, so maybe something to look at here, but probably not. He goes to cover three, and he decides to give me the flats. What you'll find is that most people will give you the flats. I mean, if you play me, I'll give you the flats for most of the game, and then I'll take it away. So that's something that you got to constantly kind of evaluate, is the flats open or not. I mean, that's really very, I mean, that's the essence of what we're going to be most of the game. If you watch the game, what you'll find is he'll be in this cover three with the curl flat zones where he takes away the deep. And then out of nowhere, he'll probably switch into a cover two hard flat. What I have to be able to do is identify when is he in that. So, like, right now, it looks like he could potentially be in that cover two hard flat. Where we want to kind of focus is on the middle here. So nope, cover three, check down to our crosser. And we got a good game. A lot of it is about calming down, in my opinion. You've got to figure out your pre-snap hypothesis. In my opinion, what most people fail to do is they fail to read the defense whatsoever. And it really does affect... And it just really does. It really does affect your ability to execute. We motion the wrong guy. This is a butchered play. I keep dropping my microphone. Yep. Not very good. Not very good right there. Luckily, we ran a draw, so it didn't really matter. So here he sets up. He's potentially blitzing off that right side again. Yep, blitzing off that right side. We've got the smash concept wide open. Kelvin Benjamin, beautiful catch. Beautiful execution there. So he went cover two. and I probably pushed the flats down so that they would take away that quick out or that, you know, the quick route, and we were able to really do a good job there. Red zone offense, I try to not make it that much different than my every down offense. Reason being is I love the fact that he's probably still thinking about PA post and also Z spot and like other plays like that. And I could potentially be able to get, be able to get something in there. Let's see what we can do here. There we go. High pass lead. Beautiful. Tight end. So looks like he went to LB Dogs, but what he did was he put his what did he do? He put his corners in flats, which is pretty cool. One thing that's interesting, I might need to start doing is put Derrick Henry on this route. Kelvin on this route. Let's see if this works. Totally late on that read. Had Derrick Henry wide open, and I totally was late. My finger slipped, and I just was late on that read. A little mistake. So defense, he's got about 3 minutes. Another thing to think about is, like, time. Like, he's got 3 minutes. What are some of the things that he might want to do here? And more importantly, what are some of the things that, like, as a defense, like, what are some key things that I feel like we need to take away in this type of situational down and distance, and where do I need to be fundamentally sound? Like, he's probably going to come out, try to bounce back with a touchdown here, obviously. And he's probably going to do that by starting slow, maybe go with a running game, maybe go a little quick pass game, kind of something like that. There we forced a post route. We were able to bleed right into that in the cover two zone. Not too bad there. That's just kind of intuition. That was nothing extraordinary. That was one of those things, like, you play so much, you get reps, and eventually you start to feel like when they're going to do certain things, what routes bleed into what. If they run a slant route, that means they're probably coming back with a post on the backside, that kind of thing. So we were able just to kind of sniff that out. That really wasn't a, you know, something I could give you in a tip. That was just kind of intuition. So as an offense, what you have to understand too is, again, you gotta figure out, number one, how to go for the big play, but how to keep it simple and just execute. Just execute, 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 execute. And if you out-execute your opponent, what you'll find is you will win more football games. What most people try to do, though, is they try to win the game in one play as opposed to playing the game every play. Every play has different things. Every time we go on the field, like, if you just watch, like, he's giving me different looks here. Look at the linebackers. He's not blitzing me. He can't blitz me. I know the game well enough to know what blitzes work and what blitzes doesn't. He goes to that cover two. Oh, that's not what I wanted. I wanted Kelvin Benjamin on a streak. Why did he run a curl route? I did not call stick. That's ridiculous. That should have been a touchdown. Keep our three receivers. See, and sometimes we can take advantage of a formation breakdown like that. So, like, for example, right there, one thing he did, if you go back and look at the film, like, he had a formation breakdown. Like, he's just stacking everybody in. And we can every now and then take advantage of that with a formation. But what we want to do is we want to keep it in our standard playbook. And that's why we start with trips. And if he's not defending the trips, then we will do that quick little boom, quick little handoff, three men on one side kind of thing, if we have that. But if we don't have it, it becomes more of a back to a balanced game. No safety help over the top. Probably going to be man-to-man. Yep, there it is. There's Fitz, wide open touchdown. Went with a little cover zero of blitz, brought the safeties down. See, I think the key is not having the perfect play. I think the key is identifying the weakness in the defense that you're facing and exploiting it with your route combinations. And most people, what they would do, in my experience, is what most people do is not that at all. down with that one. That was pretty bad. I don't know what I was doing there. I called, tried to change up a couple things and didn't work. Robert Aguayo. Why am I going for two, you might ask? Okay, so why do I go for two? Because I trust my defense. Some people ask me that, like, why do you go for two all the time? Number one is I trust my goal. I would rather play. I want you to go for two because my defense, in my opinion, is that good in the goal line. I have a lot of confidence in my ability to stop you inside the 10-yard line. I just have a lot of confidence in my ability to stop people in the 10-yard line. And so what that allows me to do then as a result is it makes it so that I can – it makes it so that what am I trying to say here? Basically, what it comes down to is I feel comfortable going for two and making it a game of, like, if you score two, I score two. I just trust my defense. And so what I'm really wanting is I want you to go for two. That's why I go for two on offense. You know, not necessarily because I have the greatest two-point conversion, but I feel like my offense is okay. But it's more about my ability to just – I feel really, really good in my ability to stop you from getting 2 points. So I hope that's enough of an explanation. Let's see here if this works. Oh, we didn't put anybody in freaking flat zone. Dang it. Oh, that was a failure. I knew he was going to that play. I just totally called the wrong defense. Too much time to throw the ball there. Baited him right there. Got him to somehow, I somehow got him to believe that I was going to the, that I was going to go play the, That was a really interesting little play. That tight end kind of did a cool little thing there, but I got him to believe I was going to the in route and recovered pretty well. Again, that's just a feel play. That's just one of those things that you just get with time. Let's see what we can do here. Stupid. You've got to know what the situation calls for. Terrible, terrible execution on my freaking, my fault. That was terrible on my part. Terrible execution right there. Dang it. I was handed a gift and I just butchered it. I can't believe I did that. It's so stupid of me. What a catch. See, that just pisses me off. We have so many people right in the vicinity, and he just rat catches it. Like, seriously, that is one of the dumbest things. It, like, dumbfounds me about this game. Like, I mean... There, he makes me return it, so I'll just take a little fall down motion. Gosh, I can't believe we freaking gave up that safety. Dang it. Christmas. We just gave that up. Stupid safety. So, like, in this situation, so if I score a touchdown here, I'm in good shape. You got to catch that, Kelvin Benjamin. Come on, buddy. Make the catch. Make the catch. So he's going press. See, it looks like right here he might be trying to get a little pressure off that left side. One thing I will do is sometimes I'll leave that tight end over there, and it can give me a hot read. Like, what the heck's going on? What are you doing? Like, that's so stupid. That shouldn't have happened. Oh, it's so annoying. Two times I've left a stupid tight end over there. We've been throwing interceptions. Pick that off. Are you serious? That is ridiculous. He's right there. He's right there, Calvin Pryor. That is literally right there. How could you suck so bad? I can't believe that this game has turned like this. God, that is terrible. Terrible offensive football. Oh, what? Jeez. Nope. The key in special teams, in my opinion, is to not lose the game. Like, you can't win a game, like, especially with the game, the way the game plays this year, like, I just don't feel comfortable in special teams. Where I feel really comfortable is offense and defense. Like, I mean, we've made a couple of bad decisions. Personally, I think it's more of like bad execution than bad decisions. Wide open. Don't drop the ball, Kelvin. My Kelvin Benjamin catches it or drops it on that one play. We had him like 45 yards down the field wide open. This guy covered. Just, I'm going to catch it. One thing, if you notice, we haven't been doing is we haven't been slowing down enough to, like, think through, like, what coverage is he in? Like, when that safety drops on the right side, is he going to go to cover three? Like, those questions are questions you've got to understand and analyze, because if you don't, you'll make bad reads because you're not predicting what they're doing. You're not assuming. So you have to have at least something to kind of, like, feel the game. And if you notice, like, when we were playing really well, we were slowing down. We were thinking, okay, and I could call it out. I was calling, like, he's a man, he's in zone, he's in this, he's in that. As the game has kind of progressed on, I've gotten a little bit lax in that, and what has happened is we have made a ball game out of a 12-0, my ball. Like, we shouldn't even be talking anymore. The game should be over. So here's probably going to blitz off that left edge. So I got to be ready for that. But that's wide open. He's been leaving Henry open on that route I don't think he's been covered yet on that out route. Gotta check those safeties. So single high safety here, probably cover three. Where I want to attack here is that route right there to Clark, that little quick out. It's pretty. So he goes cover one man. I don't know that he went that yet. He's been primarily in cover three or cover two. Every now and then he'll blitz. So like here, if you look at the formation, we've got more people on the left than he's got on the right. If I motion the tight end, it's not gonna help anything out. So like what I'll do is I'll just, run. One thing I'm starting to really learn about running the ball in Madden, and I think Le'Veon Bell is like the perfect example in real life, is you have to set your blocks up. I don't do a good job of that at all. So, like, here, this situation stacks the box, probably too high, potential blitz off the left side. What I want to do is check my quick release. Nope, he blitzes off the right. There's my quick release. And there's Derrick Henry powering forward for a few yards. Again, when you systematically walk down the field, in my opinion, that's what you want to do. You don't want that. I mean, the big play comes, but you can't force it. If you force big plays, eventually you'll make very terrible plays. And that's what's happened. It was like I was trying to force and not even thinking through, like, what could he be? And I think that's a good lesson for us to learn is if we're watching this, you guys are watching this, like, one of the keys is to slow yourself down before the ball snap, because we get in the flow of the game and we play faster than we can. Or even than we have to. It's like here, last time, if you remember, he went cover zero blitz last time. So what we want to do, okay, there's cover zero, and there's Dallas Clark on the checkout route. And that's why sometimes I leave him on that route. Let's see. So this situation, so we're up by 8. No reason for me to go for 2 here. So we'll get our 2-possession lead back with 3:50 to play. Defense kind of come out on the field here. We'll see what we can do as a defense. He hit us up the seam on a lucky catch, really. I think it was that special, the lucky special teams run back there. Deion Sanders, prime time. Let's see what we want to do here. I'm trying to think. I mean, he's been doing a lot of the standard. Low out route. That's a streak. Got him. Nice catch. So he's been running. That's just tendency. So, like, he had ran that several times over. And we just called the play that takes that away. I mean, that's one of those things that you, as a defense, when you show the same look, but you can take it away, I think that makes you really, really dangerous. From a defensive perspective, like if I show you that it's open, right, that then I take it away, I think it makes it hard on the offense because then they're like, oh, shoot, the play I thought was going to work is no longer going to work. And I really do think it changes a lot here. So let's see here. Cover 2 brings the safety down. Quick read. Derrick Henry to the house. Break a tackle. In the end zone. See, he's trying to win the game in one play. He's trying to win the ball back. And what's what happens, man? Like, if you start making mistakes, and I'm telling you guys, like, all of a sudden people just become stupid. Like, it's to me, it's baffling how quickly someone can just turn into just very, very poor execution. Good play. I haven't quite figured out what to do with that left side on that play. I really like the right side combination to beat man-to-man. Because, like, they have to run cover 2 to stop the right side of the field. And then, but I'm trying to think through, like, what would I run on the left side? They have to run cover 2 to stop the right. Just make a tackle. He's a good player. Give him a couple yards, but make a tackle. So now he's just going to start chucking, more than likely. There we go. Yep, starts chucking. And, of course, like, why wouldn't his Kelvin Benjamin not catch the ball? How many? Wow. Right Right there. There it is. Malcolm Butler. Of course, we're stupid and we take it out. And we'll close this game out here. I mean, most people, I have not found anyone that stopped a halfback base for negative. Like, just slide in, like, nothing special. I mean, Henry, by all standards, has not had a good game on the ground. But I think what it's done is it's forced him to have to at least honor it. There's Dallas Clark. And that quick flat. Like, you can just flip it out. Boom. Just, And it's just a quick little jab. It's nothing. I mean, it's a variance of PA post. But I really do think it does a lot for it. I think it does a lot for the offense. One other thing we like to do is run a slip screen every now and then when we feel like the time's right. Like, here, we'll leave him over there. Get that first down. Again, like, Henry's gotten us some critical yards, okay? Not necessarily, you know, phenomenal. But he's gotten us some critical yards. And sometimes we'll run this little screen pass to Henry in the flat. And, I mean, you don't always, like, I was just trying to show you guys, like, that's one play that we'll use from time to time. Another play we get a lot of use out of, though, is the stick, because it does a good job against man-to-man press if we're having trouble beating man-to-man. Totally didn't beat it right there, but but yeah, that's one thing we will do, like, if we need to. Trying to show you guys some of the other arsenals here. That's pretty much, I mean, that's pretty much what we're running. We don't really run a whole lot else. And those are what I call constraint theory plays. Like, by and large, if you watch a game, normally what you're gonna see me do is you're gonna see me run halfback base. You're gonna see me run PA post. You'll see stick maybe once or twice a game. You'll see Z-spot probably a little bit more. I'll run Z-spot quite a bit. But that's pretty much, I mean, I don't do a whole lot else. There's the cutback link. See, and I think that's what a good back does, is he sets up his run. He sets up his blockers. And I think that's something I've learned this year about running the ball. Like, a lot of running the ball is about setting up your key blocks for them to win, like gliding through. One thing that Eric Dickerson did really, I think, better than anybody else was he just set up his blocks. I mean, it was just beautiful to watch him run, because he didn't have to be the fastest guy on the field. He just had to be just kind of squeezed through, and there you go. Close it out. Close the game out. Don't try to be fancy. Don't try to run up the score. Just close the game out. And we'll go on. But hope that was helpful, guys. I think the takeaway from today, if I could give you one piece of advice, don't try to win the game in one play. If you try to win the game in one play, we made a couple mistakes that game. But I think where we did better than him was we didn't try to win the game in one play. So hopefully that was helpful.